Hello, my friends. We are back in business. And the business is, of course, it's you. So today it's vitamin D. D. My friend, he told me that I need 3 of them. So here I go. Mr. Vitamin tablet. That is vitamin D, and that is not because I love the taste. As you may know, the vitamin D is protecting against COVID-19. That was a good one. I have my coffee. I have everything I need, and now I also have my daughter back in business. So she is administrating whatever I am going to talk about, but if not, she will be trusting what I say. This juice was very good. Maybe a little bit old, but I'm old too. Old and cranky. So today, what's up today? I have not decided a topic for today, but I put my guava plant outside on the veranda last Thursday, and now it's gone. I may give you a little bit of a hint here. This is the guava plant. This is it. So now it's dried up, and we have to see if something is happening. Even this plant was falling down. So I have this desperation now when this plant is tilting off. What do I do? Maybe during this video I will get some inspiration to know things that I couldn't know before. But in the meantime, it's Sunday. Churchgoers and everyone else, they are looking to see what God will do today. Me by the hand, me on the other hand, I will see what I will say today. To put verbs in my mouth is the uttermost task I can do. So, the tree, the leaves have fallen. It stood overnight outside the veranda, and it just froze. So now I cut everything down, but this tree seems to have some strength to it, because I cut one that was almost died. It seems to be dead. It seems to be died from some kind of suffering. So I cut it down, and washed away all the soil in the root system and put it down again. After a while, these leaves start from the stem and grow. And that is kind of a newborn life. So today it's someday to remind of that after dead, after seemingly things have fallen to pieces, things have been cut down, you don't throw it away, you believe in a new start. Have you felt like that before yourself? That some kind of resistance from other places on you, some kind of pushback made you suffer, made you believe that there is nothing to it, then this is the end. This is not my life anymore. This is someone else have taken over. Someone else is ruling now. I think that is a good feeling. As I talked before about the lonely feeling, which is profoundly good. Now you know that you miss someone. To feel broken down in pieces, it's a good feeling. Yet it's not something to enjoy like that, but it proves there is life. Ah, I was very cruel to this plant. I used this scissor, which is very strong. I open up the gap and cut it down. So now we are waiting for the new sprouts to bloom out from the shadow into the mist, and then yet again you get new sprouts. People go to church because maybe they need some renewal in their heart or something. They need something new in order to get something to live, continue to live. But Jesus was talking from the well within. That have everlasting, you can continue it for everlasting. And in fact, we were talking a little bit about that, because people that thrives on other people, he has to get some enjoyment, some inspiration, some comfort, some confidence. They are leaning on people like they are dependent on them. You must be there for me. I can't get enough. I need to tell you this. And it seems to be the story returning all over again. Life shouldn't be about me depending on one single person. And when you say sometimes, no, it doesn't suit my time now, then you get a crazy reaction. What can I do now without you? You are so big of a disappointment to me. Look, I have been friends with you all the time. I've been loyal to you for this long time. Now you are leaving me. Yes, the only one time you needed some rest. They give you this hardship. So next time, oh, I can forgive you for that time. Say, yes, be loyal to me and I will be your friend. And you are afraid to say, I don't have any strength left. I can't go on listening to you and keeping your, holding your hand. You are draining me of energy full time. My energy I gained is just for you to take away. That is not all right. So that is, maybe people are like that in many occasions. They have friends, as they say, friends in high places. But high places, where is that? If I knew some people in high places, maybe I'm the one in the high place. If people regard me as a friend, I'm the one that is in the high places. What do you think about that? I'm the one that is superior. I'm the one that everybody is bragging about. Oh, Ole, he is my friend. Wouldn't that be nice, Anastina?
She didn't get it.
I'm talking wildly here now. But then it's something to it, because it's something to brag about. And when people are interacting in that way, people are draining out of power. And okay, you are that important. Who will regard you as important? Oh, those in high places. Important people. I got to talk with them. That is their brag list. Someone have this brag list of where they are working, what they are doing, what kind of status they have. I'm not into that at all. If you can talk sophisticated with everybody, I'm not the one. I will be out of that business, because I'm not that sophisticated. I'm not into those people that brag about themselves in that kind of way. So something I keep out of. I like people when we can talk normal. And it's hard to take a stand. I have some people that I sometime interact with, but they know when Ole is not that attending. So they say, what do you think of that? And when they ask me, I will answer. But maybe not before, because it's their own business. It's very important to keep a distance to people's business. So I won't interfere in so much in people's business, but if they ask me, I will answer, if I can answer. And I had this recent question. He told me about his suffering, what was going on, and maybe he also did some mistakes. So, in a collegium of people, I said something which was very much appreciated. Even though he didn't dare to think that way at all, it was appreciated, because I was asked, what do you think, Ole? So I think that if you hold a little bit back on what your advice is to people, but you just cut it down, like the plant here, I have cut it down. It didn't look pretty the day before. Wow, it was shining with all these leaves. Now I'm going to make tea of the leaves. That is going to be so nice tea. So even though this plant may be dead, I don't know, I don't hope so. It can be good tea. The good tea. So when maybe people are flooding other people's business because they have so many opinions. Me, by the way, I will try to keep away from people's business. Only buy from them. If I can, if it's an interesting product, I will keep away, but I will buy and seek their advice. So today is a crazy day for big talk. We are cutting down. We are draining each other for, look at this plant. All the temperature was killing this plant. It was too cold. It had nowhere to be. He was dependent on me. I had to take him back into the room. But since I was washing, I thought it could stay out in one night. But no, that was not the right move. And I did something wrong. And the plant was suffering the whole time. Maybe it was due time to cut it down anyway. I thought like that. So maybe we need to cut some connections. Yeah, so that the connected people to you that you needed to cut off know what was the problem. Need to cut them out because there is some, it didn't connect. So you either cut it out or continue, but continue suffering. So when you cut it out, it leaves an open wound. Both sides. So it's also regarding missing people like that, feeling lonely, missing people. And when you cut down the trees like that, it's all about leaving it up to the roots to do it work. Its own work. Well, that's how it goes here. Like this Christmas tree, because it can be eaten. Now I cut it down. Maybe it can come next Christmas. This is the first Christmas tree I've eaten. But draining people out of their own energy is not good. And when people do that, and that is the interaction, maybe that's the time one should think that keep a little bit to yourself so you gain your own inspiration, so you gain your own ability to listen to other people, to not be the whole subject. That is wise. Sometimes we need the silence. Yes, to listen to What can appear. There is much to time that we don't know, but one thing is certain. All what is in time. So don't worry so much that things will not be good. I was asked to pray for a lady here time back, and it can turn out that the time will bring forth all what she is asking for, or something different, because it can be something out of the ordinary. We can pray for certain specific things. I believe in that, but believe that the answer may turn out to even be better than what you asked for. I have prayed for many things, but maybe the answer for me was not to be answered on that. I need to do some cuttings. That is the answer for me, Ole. Ole, you have to understand that cutting things off is the right answer. The one that cuts me, I hope he do it all. Time will show. In the meantime, wait and see what God can do. Wait and see what God can do. What is that? Just wait and see. Don't worry so much about things that aren't there, the thoughts that is not correct, the confusion that you have in your head. It's all part of them. Everything that will be appearing in due time. We don't make the future. The future makes us. We are at a point where we never could imagine way back. We are not time administrating. No, the time is administrated by someone else. So how can you not believe in God? How can you not trust that time is holding the reality? The time let you see. The time. Maybe we need to get out of time in order to see what's in the time. I don't like to be philosophical now, but it is part of the thing we all are talking about. You can't relate to anything without any thoughts to it. So everything is in time, and you are not above. You are within. You are part of the time. That's it. We don't even know where to go. We don't know even what to do. We do what we think we should, but we never can get enough. That is the human condition. We can't get enough. But sometimes we have to keep away, keep the distance, keep the void, keep ourselves in the void, not knowing, not defining. I believe that everything is out of void, out of time. And what's happening is for the good. It's never for the bad. Only what humans are doing is seriously bad. But the time is good. Only what you do, not doing good, but doing wrong. So my friend also said something that he, wow, it was just a confirmation of what I have been talking about all the time. Just do the right thing. It will be right for everybody. Even it's hard to say sometimes the right thing, it will match up. It will go with also those that can't admit to the facts. Just say the right thing. Be honest. You will be set free. The truth will set you free. And do the right. Who knows what's right? I agree to that. I don't know. I have no clue to what is right. That is beyond me. But in my limited state, I know what's right. At least, if I don't do the right, it will be wrong. So in some sense, we have to judge. But only when we are clear, when we have a sober mind. So keep sober. As long as it doesn't depart you from your brother, do it. But when you do something that departs you from your brother, then you have something else. That is evil. That is wrong. But do right. In order to keep connection, do right. In order for new life to spring out. So I hope I did the right thing cutting this tree down. But we have to do right, because either it's otherwise it will be wrong. So we have two choices all the time. We have two choices all the time. So when you do the right thing, maybe to cut down is good, but you need to let things grow. Don't lose hope. Don't lose trust. Believe. Most of all, believe in time. What can I say? Time is everything. How simple is that? Who can beat that simplicity? That time is everything. I can't. And I said it. Time is everything. Time is of the essence, but it's everything. So when you do something, don't do it because you are angry or just excited. Do it because it's right. So my friend here gave me this inspiration to say these things today. And churchgoers, followers or leaders, keep your path straight. Do what's right. Otherwise, keep yourself in the mist. And get the inspiration from above, beyond time, beyond the limitations of now. So we have all the abilities to do it. Yes, be prepared. Have a good day, my friends.